Earlier, kids were given calcium sandals. We used to take calcium tablets. Then, new research came out that suggested taking vitamin D with calcium. Calcium tablets alone can create problems. They can increase blood pressure. Then, another research came out that suggested taking vitamin D and vitamin K2 together. Today's research is a bit different. It states, even if you are taking a vitamin D supplement, is sun exposure necessary? I'll talk about the same thing today and will tell you about some hidden symptoms of vitamin D deficiency. Slow healing of the wounds, excess sweating on the head, fatigue, dizziness when you stand up after a long time of sitting, bone and muscle pain, catching frequent infections. The Journal of Clinical Endocrinology and Metabolism observed the patients suffering from COVID-19 and tested their vitamin D levels. 82.2% of patients were vitamin D deficient. There's a direct relationship between vitamin D and infections. The last hidden symptom is that patients with vitamin D deficiency have 2.5 times more chances of getting Alzheimer's and dementia. Another research which I read at Grassroots Health Nutrient Research Institute states that if you are magnesium deficient, then your requirement for vitamin D increases by 2.5 times. Now I'll come to the main topic, sun exposure. When COVID-19 was at its peak, I often used to ask my functional doctors, what should I advise? Functional medicine doctors use specialized training and techniques to find the root causes of diseases. Doctors in America or India all said one thing, Palak, people who have taken COVID vaccines or have infections, give them melatonin. I'm a research freak, so I gave them melatonin just because doctors told me to do so. Today, I have another research. I'm not recommending melatonin which is present in my product Sleepwell. Instead of that, I'm recommending sun exposure. Why? Because when the sunlight falls on you, it consists of two things. One is visible light, which you can see, and the other is heat. What is this heat? This heat is near-infrared rays that penetrate deeply into your body and activate cytochrome C oxidase. When this cytochrome is activated, it produces melatonin inside your cells. Now, what is the relation between melatonin and corona? Your body has a pre-oxidant which is known as angiotensin II. Let's call it AG2. It is a pro-oxidant which is not good for your health as it increases blood pressure. During COVID-19, most of the mortalities were due to blood clotting. Your body makes an enzyme that directly converts AG2 into AG17. AG17 is an antioxidant, which means that your body should have less AG2 and more AG17. Now, understand what coronavirus used to do. It held the enzyme that was responsible for this conversion, and AG2 was elevated in the patient's body and AG17 used to fall, due to which they were dying. Melatonin helps this enzyme not getting bind with the coronavirus. That's why the functional doctors are saying those who are infected with corona or who have taken the vaccine for that, these people have to take melatonin for at least 1 to 1.5 years. Getting a sun exposure for as little as 10 minutes in morning increases the melatonin production in your skin. Apart from this, melatonin helps in preventing Parkinson's, Alzheimer's, heart disease, type 2 diabetes and cancer. But you'll say, Palak, I contracted the virus but I do not have it now. The virus stays inside the body, which is why some people have shown symptoms twice. Sometimes the virus in the vaccines aggravates, so you have to boost your melatonin production, which is the most important supplement, vitamin D and melatonin in this virus-governed time. At last, I would say your body needs sun rays even if you're taking a vitamin D supplement regularly.